Well, today I've got some good news. You know that folder of your rebar shape images? Well, now it's time to throw that away because we finally have a built-in solution in Revit for rebar shapes and schedules. So with the latest version of Revit, Revit 2024, we now have rebar shapes as something that's generated automatically inside of Revit as it should be done. And in this video, I'm just going to be showing you how to do that. Let's go. Now, quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up just below this video in the description and then also up in the cards above. That's where you can check out all of my Revit courses. So if you're serious about learning Revit, that's definitely the best place to be. Also there, you can find some of my Revit templates. You can find some Revit families, and we also have a plugin which you might want to check out. Okay, so now without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. The first step for creating a bar bending schedule is to create a schedule. So we go here to the project browser, find the schedule quantities, right click, and then go to new schedule quantities, and this will open up a new schedule window. Now here, what you want to do is you want to scroll down and find the category for structural rebar. I'm just going to select it and then click OK. Now, that's going to open up the schedule properties, and then here in the properties you can pick out the fields, but the main field that we're looking for today is going to be the bending detail. I'm just going to transfer it over to the schedule fields and make sure that you set it up in order. And now first let me add a few more fields. So I'm just going to add the bar diameter here. I'm going to add the bar length. Again, you just select it and then you click on this little arrow. Once you have added all the fields that you want to see here, then you need to set them in order. So here I want my bending detail to go to the bottom or to be the last field. So I'm just going to bring it down and then you can just click OK, and that's going to generate your rebar schedule. Now the bending details are not going to be visible in the schedule view. You can only see them if you place that schedule on a sheet. So let's go here to the sheet, and I have this one sheet, and then let's go to schedules, and this is our rebar schedule. So I can just drag it over and place it on a sheet, and now if you zoom in, you can see we actually have that bending detail images. Now this isn't going to be very visible, and it's actually really annoying how little it is. However, you can fix this. So by selecting the schedule, you can resize it by adjusting the length or the width of each column here. But to resize the rows, you have to select it and then go to the properties. Here you have the resize rows option or parameter, and then you want to set it to image rows. In this case, all of them are image rows, and then you want to set the height for each row. So at this point, by default, it has been set to 15.2 millimeters. And if I increase that to 30 millimeters and hit apply, now you can see we actually have a larger image inside of a larger field, and we can clearly read the numbers and it's not kind of all bunched up together. And there we go. That's how we can create this regular bending detail schedule. Now, what happens if you want to have a bending detail schedule, however, you don't want to set or show the numerical values here in the details themselves? You want to do something that's more resembling of what we had previously with the bending detail images, where we just have kind of the ABC values, and then here in one of the other fields we can define those values. Well, that is also possible with the new version of Revit. What you need to do is you need to make some adjustments to the bending detail field, and we also need to add some additional fields. So to show these differences side by side, what I'm going to do is go here to the project browser, find our current rebar schedule, right click, and then I'm going to duplicate this view. The new view I'm going to rename, and I'm just going to call it rebar schedule dash dimensions. Hit enter. Then I'm going to go back to our sheet, and I'm just going to place this off to the side here. So actually what I want to do is I want to have this one, which is the dimensions one first, and then this one we're going to set not with the numerical values like here, but we're going to have ABC values. Okay, so for that, what you need to do is you need to, well, go to the schedule. So that's going to be this schedule here. You want to go to fields, and then you want to include certain fields. So in this case, for this one, I want to have field A, B, C, D, E, and G. We're going to skip F for this one. Okay, so moving forward, what you want to do is move that bending detail all the way down, like so. And then also for the bending detail, you want to go here to formatting, go to bending detail, and then for field properties, you go to edit, and then we can adjust pretty much everything what happens in the bending detail image. So here, instead of showing values, I want to show names. And then as you can see, we're going to lose some of the options here. And if you want to show values, and then if you want to add some dimension styles, so on and so forth, you can do that here. In this case, I'm just going to leave things as is, and I'm just going to set this to show names. Then when you click OK and click OK again, what you're going to see is if we go back to our sheet, you can see that here now this shows A, B, C, D, E, F. Or no F, just G. And then here we have the values for each one. So A is this, B, and so on and so forth. Now, in this case, this doesn't look really good because we have so many fields just to show this small numerical value. So I'm going to show you how to kind of override that and how to use a better approach where it's going to show all of these values in one single tall field, which we already have. Okay, so what you want to do is go back to your schedule, and then you want to go back to fields, and then here you want to add an additional combined field. So you just click here on combined fields, and then you want to select this one, this one, this one, D, E, and then also G. So once you have all of these fields here, what you want to do then is you want to add a prefix, and then you also want to add a sample value and a separator. So here currently it's going to show these fields like so, and I don't like this. So what you want to do first is use a prefix. So for A, I wanted to say A equals and then space and then A. So as you can see, A equals A. And then instead of this separator as like a forward slash, what I want to do is I'm just going to add a bunch of empty spaces. So just hit the space bar a few times like this, and then I'm just going to make a selection of that, Control C, and I'm actually going to paste it to all of these. So that's going to give us some room in between these fields. And then also here, you want to do the same prefix for all of these. So I'm just going to do that. And once you're done, you can just click and it's going to look like this. So you want to see this A equals A. So this is just the value, B equals B, C equals C. And we want to see a lot of empty space in between these. So now when I click OK and then I click OK again, it's going to look like this. So again, now we have a lot of fields, but still we have the same issue. And then here we have these at the end, which look like this, which also doesn't look good. So we can just go back to the schedule and make a few more adjustments. So let's go back to fields. And for this field, I actually want to edit it and add a new name. So this is going to be dimensions. So let's just leave the field name as dimensions. And then you want to go to formatting. And here I want to take the values of A through G and just hide those fields and click OK. So now when we go to our architectural floor plan sheet, and then here you can see we have that dimension here. And also I actually want to move it in front of the bending detail. So for the last time, go back to fields, find the dimensions, and then just move it up above the bending detail. Click OK. And now when we take a look at that, it looks like this. So here we have all of the dimensions. You can see because we have added all of those spaces, that's why it kind of separated these into different rows. And that's what we want to see. And now we have the dimensions here for each one, and it's easy and clear to read each one of these values. So those are the two approaches to use the new bending details that came with the newest version of Revit, Revit 2024. Thank you for watching, and if you want to get access to all of my Revit project files like this file over here or any of my other Revit project files from YouTube tutorials, you can find all of those on my Patreon page, which I'm going to link up just below this video in the description and then also up in the cards above. I've got over 500 files there and I'm adding more with each video that I release. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.